Ash Ketchum has trained countless Pokemon over the years. Some we love, and some are on Pheasant. But now that his journey's coming to an end, it's time to finally create the definitive ultimate Pokemon team for Ash Ketchum. When it comes to creating an ultimate Ash team, something to keep in mind is the fact that there technically isn't such a thing as a perfect team. Every possible team combination has their own strengths and weaknesses, so it really depends on who Ash is facing and the Pokemon they're gonna use. If Ash faced a trainer with 6 ground types and he pulled up with Pikachu, you know damn well he's not gonna do good. Or maybe he will, I don't know, I've seen the impossible before. For the sake of this video, I'll be creating the actual world champion team Ash should've used against Leon, cause let's be honest, that's what we all wanted to see. Speaking of champions, this video is sponsored by Raid Shadow Legends. So picture this, you've got yourself a brand new phone and you're looking for the best mobile game to play. Enter Raid Shadow Legends with awesome visuals, loads of powerful champions, challenging PvE bosses, and tactical PvP content. Some of the great things about Raid are the regular updates and content, there's always new stuff coming to Raid, the awakening of champions by collecting souls, the index allowing you to see any champion in the game and what their skills are, and the Doom Tower where you can climb your way up, defeat powerful bosses, and earn rewards along the way. Oh, and what do you know, that spells out Raid. Raid is celebrating their 4th anniversary, and there's tons to get excited about. I'm talking dedicated offers, free gifts, promo codes, events, and a brand new fusion event where you guys can get an anniversary themed legendary champion. You'll also be able to take a trip down memory lane with a recap video of your stats in Raid. With all this exciting stuff and more coming to Raid, if you haven't started playing, what are you waiting for? Use my link in the description or scan my QR code to get insane bonuses. We are talking an epic champion, Kellen the Shrike, and other useful things. Alright, so I lied. I'm not making Ash's ultimate team. I'm making 2 ultimate teams! Yeah, here's the thing. Greninja, an obvious choice for the team, right? Wrong. If we're going off the idea that this is the team Ash could have used against Leon, then Ash technically can't have Greninja because he's still released. Stupid Kalos Vines. So because of that, I'll be making 2 ultimate teams. There's a realistic team consisting of Pokemon Ash still owns, and then there's the unrestricted team where we have no limitations and can use any Pokemon Ash has ever owned. Sound good? Alright, now let's begin with the realistic team. When it comes to choosing the members, we'll refer to my tier list ranking all of Ash's Pokemon by strength, as this takes care of a lot of the heavy lifting. And as you can see, this list is only counting Pokemon Ash owned or could have called upon during the Master's 8. If you haven't seen the original or updated tier list, here's what each of the tiers mean. Now since we're making a team that's meant to face the strongest trainer in the world, obviously we shouldn't be using any of the bubble blowing babies in the lower tier. So we're only sticking to champion tier Pokemon or higher. The first pick is an obvious one, Ash's partner Pikachu. You can't have an ultimate team without him. Not much needs to be said here as we already know how awesome and reliable Pikachu is. He's taken down a number of legendaries, he can use his own Z-move, can even Gigantamax, and it was the one that gave Ash the final win to become world champion after all. With our first and main member picked, we can now build the rest of the team around him. And right away, we need a Pokemon that can deal with Pikachu's ground weakness. So for that, the second Pokemon will be Sceptile. This green boy is famously known for his shitty win rate. I mean, taking down Tobias' Darkrai. On top of his raw strength, Sceptile is also fast enough to catch a speed form Deoxys, proving that it truly is on par with legendaries and mythicals. Next, we need a Pokemon that can help with Sceptile's weaknesses, since he's got quite a few. That explains the win rate, I guess. Pikachu covers Sceptile's flying weakness, so the next best choice would be a fire type, to take care of 2 of the remaining 4 weaknesses. But here's the thing though, which of Ash's fire types do we add to the best team? Ah yes, Charizard versus Infernape. A debate as old as time, or as old as Diamond and Pearl. And I know some of you might want to throw Incineroar to the mix, and you know, he's a great Pokemon, he's a cool dude, but since evolving he hasn't really done anything, so it's kind of hard to put him in the same tier as these two. The real question here is which of these two is the most beneficial for the team. It's a bit tricky because both have different secondary typings that each bring their own pros and cons for the team. So for the time being, let's hold off on that until we have the rest of the team set. Our fourth member of the ultimate team will be Lucario. Because of Ash's aura ability, him and Lucario have formed an inseparable bond, allowing them to reach greater heights in battle. This is called plot armor. Because of this bond, they were quickly able to master Mega Evolution, and when they're totally in sync, Lucario can even bust out the deadly giant aura sphere. He's basically Ash Greninja after Ash Greninja left. He's been able to take down Raihan's G-Max Duraludon, Leon's Mr. Rhyme, and even Cynthia's Garchomp, so this easily proves that he deserves his spot on the team. His typing also takes care of our fire type's rock weakness, and even gives us immunity to Sceptile's poison weakness. We do get an added fighting, ground, and fire weakness to the team though, so we gotta deal with that. Ground I'm not too worried about right now as we already have Sceptile, so let's address fire and fighting. And no, this is not foreshadowing for Infernape. Now the fifth member might be a surprise, but it's Ash's Gengar. Even though I have him ranked as the weakest of Ash's Journeys team, he's still a champion level Pokemon. He's been able to take down two of Raihan's Pokemon, Steven's Aggron, and even Leon's Inteleon. So like Pikachu and Lucario, he's already taken on the world's strongest. On top of that, he's got one of the best move pools, thanks to attacks like Shadow Ball, Sludge Bomb, and Dazzling Gleam. And his typing gives us a lot of resistances, and even immunity to normal and fighting types. Best of all, Gengar has the ability to Gigantamax, and is the Ash Pokemon with the most experience with that. And would you look at that, we now have all three of Ash's gimmick Pokemon on the team. And like, why wouldn't you do that? Like every other Pokemon though, Gengar brings his own weaknesses to the team. That being Ghost, Psychic, Dark, and Ground. Oh god. I'll address that soon, but as for Gengar's other weaknesses, Dark is taken care of by Lucario, and Gengar has Dazzling Gleam just in case. Ghost, Gengar can kinda do himself as well if you wanna be risky, so that really only leaves us with Psychic to worry about. Luckily, our final member is here to take care of that. The sixth member of this ultimate team is Ash's Crocodile, a very cool and underrated Pokemon. And I'm not just saying that because he knows how to Crocorock a pair of killer shades. Crocodile is actually perfect for this team. His typing not only gives us immunity to electric types, but also immunity to Gengar's psychic weakness, and can even deal with Sceptile and Lucario's fire weakness. So that takes care of that problem. What truly makes Crocodile such a good choice, however, is the fact that it's the perfect counter to Leon's Cinderace. This Cinderace is probably Leon's most annoying member due to its Libero ability changing Cinderace's typing. Luckily, Crocodile's diverse move pool allows it to deal with almost all of Cinderace's possible typings. It uses Pyro Ball, then go for Stone Edge. It uses Iron Head to become a Steel type, let's use Dig. High Jump Kick into Fighting type, catch this Aerial Ace. The only thing Crocodile can't really cover is Scorching Sands, which would turn it into a Ground type. It always comes back to the Ground types, doesn't it? Fine, let's tackle this. Clearly, Ground is the biggest threat to this team. And even though we have Sceptile, we can't fully rely on it when so many Pokemon are weak to it. Have you seen this guy's win rate? If Sceptile goes down early, Ash is in big trouble. So with that in mind, we now go back to the question asked earlier. Charizard or Infernape? Yeah, if you can put two and two together, it should be more than obvious that Infernape does not belong on this team, I'm sorry. It sucks because I really love him. He's strong, his Blaze ability's broken, but Infernape's typing would be more of a liability than an asset to this team. We already have three Pokemon weak to ground, we don't need a fourth. Charizard, on the other hand, is immune to ground thanks to its flying typing. Plus, if you just compare the two, it's really no contest. Infernape's coverage isn't that great, but Charizard, on the other hand, is packing Flamethrower, Dragon Tail, Slash, and Wing Attack. Okay, I know those last two aren't that great, but at least it's something. Also, when it comes to feats, Charizard has just proven itself more by being able to defeat an Articuno. Meanwhile, Infernape struggled with a Moltres. So there you have it, Ash's most realistic ultimate team that he should have used against Leon. I'd argue that this team is so good that they probably would have given Ash a 100% win against Leon. Don't believe me? Sceptile could beat Inteleon, Lucario beats Mr. Rime, Gengar beats Dragapult, Crocodile beats Cinderace, Charizard beats Rillaboom, and Pikachu beats Charizard. That sounds pretty good to me if I do say so myself. But what about Ash's unrestricted ultimate team? Who should he choose if he could use any Pokemon he's ever owned? Well, let's go back to the strength tier list, this time including everyone. Now I know what you're thinking, oh, just pick his 6 strongest Pokemon, but it's not really that simple. Same as the first team, we start with Pikachu. He's a must. Next up is Greninja. Yes, your time has finally come, my boy! He's the natural next choice because he takes care of Pikachu's ground weakness. Also, he's just really strong thanks to the power of
Satoshi Gekkouga.
When Ash and Greninja were just tapping into this form, they were able to hold their own against Diantha's Mega Gardevoir. And although he got released, Pokemon Journey shows that Greninja has not lost his edge, and has gotten even stronger since then without even using the Ash Greninja form. I refuse to believe it's retconned. So yeah, he's an easy pick for the ultimate team. Next, we have Nebi. It's a legendary and Ash's strongest Pokemon, so adding him is a no-brainer. Ash might not have caught it, but it's still his, goddammit. Solgaleo works so perfectly alongside Greninja, cause they balance each other out. Its Psychic and Steel typing takes care of Greninja's Fighting and Fairy weakness, meanwhile Greninja's Water and Dark typing resists Solgaleo's Ghost, Fire, and Dark weaknesses. But oh no, I sense that Ground weakness coming back, so bam, here's Sceptile. Next is Infernape to take care of Greninja and Sceptile's bug weakness, while also giving us that sweet, sweet ground immunity. Wait, did I say Infernape? I meant Charizard. Yeah, it's Charizard again. Literally for the same reason as before. I'm sorry, Infernape, but until you can defeat a legendary and can learn some more coverage moves, Charizard is just gonna have to take your spot. I don't know what else to say. Honestly, I can see Infernape being in an ultimate team, but it comes with some sacrifices. He works best when you build a team around him and not Pikachu. But anyways, that leaves us with one more slot, and of course, it's gonna go to Lucario to take care of Charizard's rock weakness. A really good substitute though is Camon. And technically, if you're not counting strength, it is the better option, since that's one less ground weakness to worry about, and he has better type coverage with his moves. But because Ash and Lucario share a strong bond and Mega Evolution, realistically, it's the one that Ash would go with the most. Huh, and now I'm realizing that these Pokemon really are just the 6 strongest minus Infernape. I guess it really was that simple. And there you have it, Ash's realistic and unrestricted ultimate teams. What do you think? Let me know in the comments as well as your ultimate Ash team. That's gonna be it for me though, so thank you all for watching. Shout out to the amazing channel members for their support, and consider joining as well to watch these videos days early. Last but not least, make sure to live your life to the fullest, and have yourself a damn good one.